Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In last video, I repaired this mobile charger. In this charger, I found these two capacitors unserviceable. The original capacitors were 470 microfarad 10 volt, but I installed 470 microfarad 16 volt for test purpose. When I was looking at circuit, it is using very strange IC. The number printed on this IC is 5V70DA14A. When I checked data sheet, no information is available on the internet. Let's see its configuration. This is AC input terminal. Then this zigzag, it is fuse. This track is working as a fuse. One line is reaching here, second line is reaching here. Then we have two output points, this one and this one. This is negative terminal, it is reaching to capacitor negative pin, and the second pin is positive. Positive is reaching to capacitor positive terminal, that is here. First line, fuse. Second line, directly to bridge rectifier. AC terminal, positive, negative. It is applied to this capacitor. It is 10 microfarad 400 volt. Then we see the positive terminal that is connected to this capacitor resistor, and the same positive terminal from this point it is reaching to transformer primary winding. And here we have one capacitor, one resistor and one diode. These are in parallel. The resistor is 474 470k, and diode is A7. It is 1N4007 A7 SMD diode 474 for capacitor. I will make a detailed video how we can identify these capacitors which don't have any marking. I will share the technique how we can identify the capacitor value. Then we see this IC number 1 pin here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, number 7 is missing, number 8 is connected to capacitor ground. 5, 6, these are drain pins, and this is our primary ground. Pin number 8, that is primary ground. The same positive terminal that is connected here, same is connected to this resistor 2 mega ohm, 205 code resistance, and it is connected to pin number 1. Same positive voltage, 205, 2 mega ohm resistor, it is connected to pin number 1. This resistor between positive here, and it is going to pin number 1. At pin number 1, we have one capacitor here, that is here, it is VCC pin. This capacitor second side, these two holes, these are interconnected through this PCB to the capacitor negative terminal. Pin number 2 is connected to capacitor, and that capacitor second end is connected to ground. It is compensation pin. Because I don't have a data sheet, I am just only considering these functions by the circuit configuration. Pin number 2 is connected to capacitor. Might be this is compensation pin. Pin number 3 connected to resistors. Then if you see here, here is a resistor that is connected at this point. A resistor is connected between these two points. It is 1.5 ohms resistor. It is current sense resistor. So the current will flow from here to the drain pin, and it will provide to transformer primary winding. Then we have these two connections, that is auxiliary winding. One end of the winding is connected to primary ground. The second end, that is connected to this diode. I will draw this auxiliary winding here. One end of this winding is connected to ground. Then we have diode, and it is going to pin number 1. And the same diode point that is connected to these two resistors, these are in series, 1 2. One end is provided to this auxiliary winding voltage without rectification. Then we have these two resistors in series, and the center load is connected to pin number 3. From this point, we have two resistors. It is connected to pin number 3. It is offline switcher. In offline switcher, there is no optocoupler based feedback network. It will sense the voltage from this bias winding, from this VCC winding. How much current is there? It will sense from the current sense resistor. And how much voltage are there in the output? It will check from these two resistors, 433 code and 432 code. 4.3K. And this is 43K, 433 code. I am writing SMD codes. Then we have output winding, that is here. In the secondary side, we have these two points, this one and this one. This point is connected directly to the negative terminal of these two capacitors. Here, here, and it is also connected here to the common mode capacitor. But if we locate this point from here to here, we have this diode, it is SS54. Anode of SS54 is connected to this winding, and the second rectifier, that is SS34. Its anode is also connected to the same point. Anodes are connected together, cathodes are connected together, cathodes are reaching to these two capacitors. So we can say in secondary we have two diodes, two capacitors in parallel. Secondary winding, SS54, SS34. Output of these rectifiers is connected to these capacitors. These are 470 microfarad, 10 volt. We have 5.2 volt out, 3 ampere. Then we have another capacitor, that is blue capacitor, common mode capacitor. It is connected between the primary ground and the secondary ground. Class Y capacitor, that is this one, blue one. If you have data sheet for this IC or you have any information, please, if you can send data sheet. 5V, this is number printed on the IC. 7ODA14A, this is IC number. In upcoming video, we will make its practical test. We will check its supply voltage. We will check the current sense signal and how much frequency, duty cycle, at which method this IC is working. It don't have any optocoupler, any feedback system. It measures the voltage that are provided through auxiliary winding. And it compares the current. So it will limit the current and it will manage the voltage. When we put loads, the voltage will drop. When these voltage will drop, in result these voltage will increase due to reverse EMF. When these voltage will increase, it will increase its duty cycle to compensate the voltage drop. It will monitor the current and it will monitor the voltage. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.